my name is Victor Acuna. I'm a 10th grader at Firebaugh High School in Lynwood, and my project is called Shine 2.0. So my hypothesis was to be able to create a search and rescue robot using Arduino and a variety of sensors and modules in order for the first and rescue robots to be able to know the environmental status as well as the location of humans during natural disasters. And that data will be used for the first responders, so that way they know if it is safe for them to go and help and rescue that person or not. And also if a human is actually in that area in need of help. So my prototype was a search and rescue robot, which included a PIR sensor, which is used to detect the humans, and a green LED so that the people nearby can know if they have been found or not. I've also included a smoke sensor as well as a buzzer and red LED. So that way, if any smoke or dangerous gases are found in that area, then the people can be alerted and they can have the opportunity to leave if they can do so. Also, I have included a cheap acrylic base, which is around $15, as well as a Bluetooth module. And that Bluetooth module will send the readings of the PIR sensor to the first responders. There's also TT motors in the prototype, as well as plastic wheels, and that allowed for mobility. And to know where the robot is going, we included an Android phone that was free, and we used the camera as a live stream. And we also control the robot wirelessly with an app. So we also used 9-volt batteries to power the whole entire thing. So there was a lot of flaws with our initial design. One of them being that the PIR sensor did not cover that much area, so we had to include another PIR sensor in the back of the car for the final design. As well as the buzzer for the sort of smoke sensor wasn't that loud, so we needed to include a louder buzzer. Then another thing was the LEDs. They were not seen from a very far distance, so we included more LEDs, two of each kind, two red and two green. The acrylic base that I had initially was very, very flimsy, and it broke easily. So we included a 1/4-inch acrylic base, which was more durable and will protect the interior of the car. We have also included VEX motors and tread links to provide even more mobility, and that covered flat surfaces, hills, and rocky terrains, unlike the TT motors, which only covered flat surfaces. We have also included rechargeable batteries, and that allowed for the robot to last longer. Initially, it only lasted around 10 minutes. Now, it could last 3 days before it dies. So the total cost initially of our prototype was $58. Our final design now is around $190, and it isn't that expensive because it could easily be replaced now if anything bad happens to this robot. So my hypothesis was correct. I was actually able to create a search and rescue robot that was cost effective, yet efficient, and was able to do many things that the search and rescue robots in the market can do. I would like to thank Jim Goodall for their mini grant, which allowed me to build this robot, as well as my teacher, Ms. Sharoni, who went back and forth and to help me out in order to make this video possible.